The papyrus put it on my table every month. I don't wanna miss it.
This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in glory land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me in heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Just over in
to show that this all-surpassing power is from God and not from us. We are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed, perplexed, but not in despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed. We will always carry around in our body the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be revealed in our body. For we who are alive are always being given over to death for Jesus' sake, so that his life may be revealed in our mortal body. So then, death is at work in us, but life is at work in you. It is written, I believed, therefore I have spoken. With that same spirit of faith, we also believe, and therefore we speak, because we know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus from the dead will also raise us with Jesus and present us with you in his presence. All this is for your benefit, so that the grace that is reaching more and more people may cause thanksgiving to overflow to the glory of God. Therefore, we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory, and that far outweighs them all. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen or what is unseen, for what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. May the Lord bless his reading of his word.
Thank you. Second Bible reading from the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 15, the 50th verse, all the way to the 58th verse. Sorry.
I'm reading from 1 Corinthians, chapter 15, from verse 50 to the end. I declare to you, brothers and sisters, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Listen, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed. In a flash, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For the perishable must clothe itself with the imperishable, and the mortal with immortality. When the perishable has been clothed with the imperishable and the mortal with immortality, then the saying that is written will come true. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Praise the Lord.
And once more, we'd like to commiserate with the family and to pray that God will continually comfort every one of us. There's a common saying in Hausa that mutua ridankuwani. It's just that we all wear it at a different point in time. So, and how many of us would like to go to heaven here? You don't want to go to heaven? Some people are not raising it. Praise the Lord. Well, I have good news for you. There are only two ways you can go to heaven. Number one, you must die. Okay? Number two is by rapture. For us believers, the Bible says that when we are mourning, we should mourn like them that have hope. Hope with the fact that we are going to have an eternal life. Or we are going to live eternally together with our Savior Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. So you have only one responsibility. Before the preacher comes up, I would just want to encourage you. One responsibility. You have to believe in the death, the resurrection, the burial of our Lord Jesus Christ. Once you believe that he has taken away all your sins and you accept him as your Lord, then you're on your journey to heaven. Praise the Lord.
Who has the final say? Jehovah has the final say. Who has the final say? Jehovah has the final say. Jehovah turns our lives around. Besides, can I doubt his tender mercy, who through life has been my guide? Heaven is divinest comfort, here by faith in him to dwell. For I know what had befall me, Jesus to wait all this well. For I know what had befallen me, Jesus, to wait all this well. All the way my Savior leads me, chase each wind in path I tread, gives me grace for every trial, feeds me with the living bread. When my very steps may falter and my soul at last may be crushing from the rock before me, Lord, spring of joy I see. Gushing from the rock before me, Lord, spring of joy I see. All the way my Savior leads me, all the fullness of his love, perfect rest to me is promised in my Father's house above. When my soul with all the mortal wings his flight to realms of day, this my song through endless ages, Jesus led me all the way. Master Jesus, who came and gave us life, who came and died on the cross and crossed all our problems and our calamities. I just want to return thanks to the Almighty. He is awesome. He is great. He is God and God indeed. I just want to share the last moments I had in the hospital with my daughter. My daughter four times mentioned that she felt her spirit was leaving her. And I said, no, your spirit will not leave you because you are not going anywhere. Times she will weep. When I ask her, why are you crying? She will say she's worried about her son and those who look up to her. Then three times, she laughed and laughed loud. I said, why are you laughing, ma? She will say, because she knows that she's going to rest very soon. 2 times, she saw she was dressed in white robes with a crown. Twice. You know, so I just want to share this last moment with her and to assure everybody here that my daughter is at the right hand of God, resting with the Creator, where one day we'll meet never to part again. Thank you very much.
May the Lord will continue to strengthen you, to help you, and to uphold you by his right hand of righteousness. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Well, thank you very much. We are all heartbroken, and it's not a showbiz, it's not a time to celebrate what we have done. Papa's magazine has been telling me, write your tribute. It was difficult for me to, I've written it, but it's not when people have to see what we have to write and we say that Alex was there or because Alex did that. You know, something significant about Rachel. I don't know how many people that spoke to Rachel 24 hours before her death. I don't know how many people knows what Rachel did 24 hours before her death. Rachel is not just my best friend. She's one of my best media colleagues. We do a lot of things, but this is no time to celebrate that. The significant thing Rachel did within 74 hours, I didn't even know she was in the hospital. It was sad I couldn't make it to the candlelight because I know that would have been a time for us to say some of these things. But if I don't say it, I don't think she will be happy with me. On a very beautiful afternoon, I got a call from Rachel. She said, Alex, give me 3 ladies, intelligent, smart, that work as a PR for a company. That was like 48 hours before her death. I asked, Your Majesty, I think before that time, she said, Alex, I need a red carpet host for a program. I said, did you travel? Because I felt, because before then, we were talking about her Kaduna trip. I just felt she went to Kaduna. She didn't actually tell you, she said she's under the weather. I wouldn't want to understand what she said, but then I just felt maybe she was not disposed. I said, do you have a red carpet suit that can start? I said, for a program. I said, okay, the one that will stand for her. I didn't know, at that moment, I didn't know she was in the hospital. I made my contact. I said, okay, I've gotten it. I think she, perhaps with the organizers, I think she, either she had to let them know that it didn't work. She now said, okay, Alex, okay, just hold on the red carpet host. Back to these ladies. That was 74 hours, then 48 hours. I need these 3 ladies for job. I made this contact because we work everywhere. When I made this contact, I made the contact and these people came. They said, go to this place. We're going to do an interview. They'll interview you. And these ladies went. Lo and behold, when they are at the door, okay, they were calling me, okay, they're trying to reach this person. I called back Rachel. I said, Rachel, what's up? She said, hold on, Alex, hold on, let me call them. She called, okay, it was a name he gave, Joshua. Let me tell this from...
They were trying to access the place.
Okay, Joshua, they tell them it's from Rachel, the piper. These ladies went. After the interview, I called her. 2 of them went. The third one couldn't make it because of the short frame of time. And when they came back, they said, Alex, most time we chat. Alex, that's beautiful. They were impressed with these ladies. The next day, they said, make sure those ladies come up for the interview, for the final appointment. This one was now 24 hours before the death. And lo and behold, these ladies went. And they called me
They were now thanking me. Alec, thank you very much. You got the job. I don't know if you should celebrate this with the wonderful club of Her Majesty.
But then,
Alec, thank you very much. We got the job. We got the job. Thank you. And those people just finished NYC. And it's something I couldn't. A day after that, I got information Rachel was dead. It was shocking to me because I didn't even know, she didn't even make it sound serious. When I had an accident in a corner, 6 months, Rachel was at my hospital bed. But then, however it is, I was so sad. I wish. It's...
Praise the Lord.
Parents of our Queen Ambassador Rachel Bakam. She hails from the Baju Chiefdom. His Royal Highness, a first-class chief, he's supposed to be here with you. Actually, there was this foundation laid stone for the building of the new palace. And Ambassador Rachel Bakam happened to be one of the prominent daughters to be there. And he asked me that I must make sure she attends that function. Then I called her. She couldn't talk to me. She simply texts that she can't talk, that she's in the hospital. Now, I just left it like that. I didn't know that it was such a serious incident that would result to death. Then I told His Royal Highness. He felt it. Then after the function, a day or two, I was now called to be informed that she has passed on. Now, when I went and told him, he couldn't believe it. He couldn't believe it. So, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, Rachel was a queen. I can assure you that. She was a prominent daughter, very, very prominent. She didn't hide where she was coming from. Wherever she went, is it in Nigeria, is it outside the country, she showed where she was coming from. That she was coming from a village in Zangonkatab, local government of Kaduna State. So today, I am speaking on behalf of His Royal Highness, conveying his condolence to the entire people gathered here, especially our friends and colleagues. May her soul rest in peace. Thank you very much.
Thank you very, very, very much, sir.
Praise God. Praise God. The biography of Rachel. Birth. Rachel Kuzayed was born into the family of Adamu Kabrug Bakam on 11 September 1982. School. She had her nursery education at Clara Nursery and Primary School. Thereafter, she attended her primary school at St. Anne's, St. Saviour's, and Capital School consecutively. Kuzayed continued her post-primary education in Capital School, where she became a head girl in her final year in 1999. On passing out of secondary school, Kuzayed proceeded to Ahmadu Bello University, Zaria, from 2000 to 2003, where she became the best all-round in drama department and faculty of arts.
In peace, like a river, sorrows like sea, billows roll. Whatever my Lord, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul.
Rachel started working and acting before graduating from the university. She worked as a presenter of a program tagged Teenager's Garden in Kaduna State Media Corporation and acted in some soap operas. One of the soap operas was titled Webs. After graduating, she established her brand called Trends and Rachel, from where she upgraded to Rachel the Piper. She also had a platform in Hausa with African Magic entitled Yenayin Zamani. Due to her drive to serve humanity, she She established the Pipa Foundation, where she reached out to the needy and indigent in the society.
It is well,
it is well
with my soul.
Marriage. Kuzayed was married to Israel Ejeren, and the union was blessed with a son. She is survived by her son, Ogene Tega Kazashim Ejeren, brothers and an aged mother. Christian life. Rachel received Christ as Lord and personal Savior in 2003 at Jawom in Zaria. Hallelujah.
Those saints trials should come. Let this assurance control. That Christ has regarded my helpless estate and shed
God that gave us an internal gift from our Lord Jesus Christ. And because of this internal gift, oh God, we do not die, we transit. We thank you because we sleep and stay still, that the next page might be opened, that we might know what is the desire, the will, and the insurmountable power of God, even in the power of his making. To these, Lord, we give you praise, we give you honor, we ask you to take the glory. Take the honor, take the adoration. Even as our sister Rachel joins the assembly, the innumerable company of angels right now to look down upon us as we give this last honor. Lord, make us honorable before you. For in Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. We're so scared of death. I don't know what is about death that causes fear. The Bible makes us to understand in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter number 15, verse 55. It says, O death, where is thy power? O grave, where is thy sting? It says that the sting of death is in sin. Nevertheless, I preach you the good news, that if you are saved in Christ, there is no longer the fear of sin. It means death can have no hold over you. You should be prepared for the appointment called death. What you fear will suddenly come upon you. But what you prepare for cannot have its place around your life. Our sister, Rachel, formerly known as Rachel the Piper, at the time, thank God, we were able to do one or two things, even at the church level. We did the animation of the Rachel the Piper opening while she was going to launch Rachel the Piper. I looked yesterday, she was just 38. I looked at the company of people that came. I'm looking at the company of people that are here today. I'm looking at royal representatives for 38 years of worthy living. It is not how long I live. It is how well I live. It is no longer how long you desire to live. Beginning from now, you need to prepare that there is a call on your life which you must answer. If that call comes, like Pastor Father says, through death, blessed be God. If the call comes through the transient living where we'll be captured with our Lord Jesus Christ in the skies, blessed be God. Sister D. I went on WhatsApp
a post that my wife showed me when Rachel and her mom were singing deep choruses unto God. She prepared for where she was going. Are you prepared for where you are going? Are you prepared even as you're seated here, listening to those words? These words that you listen to today will be accountable concerning you on the day of our Lord. We are preparing for the day of our Lord. How are you going to prepare? Rachel was prepared. So when it came, it was honorable. You need to prepare to make it honorable. Us. The chasm will be opened unto us. The reason for celebration will be opened unto us. Like it was in the life of Philip, that even Christ himself will be at attention. And will say, we are receiving a worthy ambassador. I read to your hearing. Remember, we are sojourners on the face of the earth. Don't get too accustomed and accommodated with what the earth is offering. We are eternal beings. We are spiritual beings. We are first and foremost spirit. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him would not perish but have what? Eternal life. Life is a way. The breath of God, the life of God, the eternal life of God, the spiritual life of God, the incomplete life of God, the indefinite life of God that defines all things. Can we bow down our heads? Because of the death of our sister, which is actually transition, oh God, we are here gathered to give you honor, to give you praise, to give you glory. I ask, oh God, that you touch every life here and perform a miracle in every life. I ask healing to be meted to everyone that desires a healing. And we ask that Jesus will meet everybody at their points of need. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
The papyrus, put it on my table every month. I don't want to miss it. Don't even try it.
A ritual or a religious service that you're offering, this is not a motion that you're going through. Let's pray. Ask that God will help the family. God will strengthen. God will strengthen the spouse, the mom, the son, the siblings, the cousins, the aunties, those who are close friends and associates, well wishes as well. Everyone who's been touched in a profound way, that God will be there for them. God will touch them. God will strengthen them. Ask for strength. Ask for strength. Ask for strength. Ask for the strength of God. Ask for the strength of God.
So Jesus, we thank you. We thank you because the righteous don't die, but they sleep. The righteous are seed in your hand. You sow them into the earth, expecting a harvest. For our sister, the seed that will be sown today, the harvest will not begin tomorrow, but today. We thank you for souls that you will harvest for yourself because of the life that has been lived to your glory. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We bless you, Lord Jesus. We bless you because heaven has gained. We bless you, Lord Jesus. Strengthen the family with might by your spirit in their inner man. We thank you for you raise pastors. You will raise prophets, you will raise evangelists, you will raise teachers, you will raise for yourself. You will raise for yourself offices from this family. We know even the tribe has not lost. We know, Lord Jesus. We know, Lord Jesus. This darkness is passed away. The true light is already shining. We bless you, Lord Jesus. We bless you, Lord Jesus. If at 38, you will work this testimony in her life, then Satan, be careful, because the deadliest generation you have not yet seen. Life after the burden has just been transferred. Wait, this is the generation that is a mobile violator of the natural laws of men. Death itself provoke us to love God the more. Even Mama, the wisdom of God left in her will be heard with few words. she is able to bring to bear the mind of the Spirit. So we thank you, Jesus, for our friends who are in tears right now. We know a lot of them are making a decision to change the story of their lives. We know, Jesus, people right now are seeing their end. They are seeing the messages that will be preached on the day their remains will be buried. Because right here is not Rachel. The spirit of Rachel has left this place. This used to be her address. On that day, those who are dead in Christ, they will rise up first, and we together with them will arrive at the same time. We thank you, Jesus. We are not hopeless. We have a living hope.
And we give you glory. And we give you praise. And we magnify your name. In Jesus' name.
Just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in glory land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me in heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home.
And to God I hear him come. We have to commit our body to the ground. Happy. This we do in strong and resolute hope of the resurrection to the life eternal with God in heaven forever and ever.
I'm not going to ask the family members to do same thing that I don't do.
Let's manage the situation for as well. I know he's bleeding.
This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in glory land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me in heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this.
Ashes to ashes.
The representative of the traditional
ruler.
Okay,
I'm going to pray now. Let's pray. Let's pray. In Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, even as we've committed this body to the Mother Earth, we decree and declare by your word that no every spirit of necromancers, every spirit that uses familiar spirit in order to intimidate or cause havoc in one way or the other in the family, we declare by your word that they have no right over this body. We command by the name of Jesus, sir, that every authority you have over this body is taken away completely. As this body is committed to the Mother Earth, on no account shall any familiar spirit use this body.
Amen.
To convict anyone in the name of Jesus. Amen. Satan will repeat you and will declare by the word of the Lord, as this body is committed to the Mother Earth, she rests forever.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, we have a decree, Almighty God, in this family, affliction shall not arise the second time. We understand the father passed on at the age of 38. We declare that, Lord, the work stops here.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus, we invoke the covenant of longevity of life. And we speak by the word of the Lord that touch not God's people and do them no harm. In the name of Jesus, we invoke the blood of the Lamb and we speak by the word of the Lord. No weapon formed and fashioned against them shall prosper. Every tongue written against them in judgment is condemned. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you, Father. We activate the speaking power of the blood. And we declare the blood will keep speaking for the child. The blood will keep speaking for Israel. The blood will keep speaking for the mother. The blood will keep speaking for the sibling. And every member of the family, you will live and declare the goodness of the Lord. You will fulfill your days on earth. And we decree and declare, the longer you live, the brighter you will shine, the wiser you will become, the more fulfilled you will become, to the praise and glory of God's name. So be it in the name of Jesus Christ. Let me pray for everybody here. We double pray for everyone here, Lord. We ask that, Lord, your hand will rest upon them. Nobody will die prematurely here. We will live a purposeful life in the name of Jesus. We declare that, Father, everyone here that has committed his life to you today, let it be that, Father, they will live forever for you. They will serve you in the name of Jesus. And those that are yet to make up their mind while they are at home, appeal to them, Lord. Let them serve you in the name of Jesus Christ. I cover everyone here with the blood of Jesus, and I declare the Lord bless you. The Lord make his face shine upon you. The Lord be gracious unto you as you fulfill the number of days on earth in the name of Jesus. God bless you all. Let's share the grace of fellowship while we call on now. Praise the Lord. Let's give the vote of thanks. Thereafter, we're going to ask them to cover the grave site. But before then, let's give a vote of thanks from Mr. Israel. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Israel, you're not a man of the world. For the spirit of guidance. The beauty of his charity, the fact that we can come boldly into the throne of grace, we are filling us and coming grace to help in a time of need. My special need, and that's what I told my son, my special need today is to make sure that every one of you here present, irrespective of who you are, you will take examples from Jesus and gain strength from this. The example of expression is the exemplary sacrificial life that Rachel leads, that you also can go and do likewise. To live a life almost like in a hurry. But that is what happens to many great people. The Jesus we talked about today was just 33 and she left and he left. I am convinced in my spirit that Rachel is going to be with the Lord because I was there about 45 minutes after she I asked the mother just one question. Is she at peace with God? And she recanted all the story that she's telling today. And brothers and sisters, no matter how mighty you are, if you die and go to hell, it profits you nothing. She has run her race, she's lived her life. And my advice is that run your race and live your life. Beyond and above that, I thank you very much for coming. God will not forget easily the sacrifice you've made to be here for her. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Thank you so much.
This world is not my home. I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in glory land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me in heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Just over in glory land we'll live eternally. The saints on every hand are shouting victory. Their songs of sweetest praise drip back from heaven's shore. And
the papyrus.